Hello everyone, welcome to Tower of Slight Convenience, the tower that's very inconvenient. And it's been an absolute nightmare to record. Taking me well over 8 tries to get past floor 5. To even get to floor 5. And I'm able to do difficulty towers with ease. I'm able to do tower keyboarding with ease. This tower's difficulty is a culmination of the fact that it was of the difficulty poll. And people would rate towers easier than they really are. Or because they just want a free tower to be at. This tower's honestly not been cool to record, especially floor 3. I bet people who've completed an SC before or think that this tower is above the. I mean, I bet even soul-crushing victors can't complete this tower. And yeah, crappy hyperbole, I know. The point is, the difficulty inconsistencies of this tower are phenomenal. It's even worse than Tower of Elysium. Oh yes, I get it. It's a peak hard. It's pretty much the closest thing one can get to a tower, to a difficulty tower, without going to difficulty. But so is Tower of Cosmic Tides, and that's enjoyable. Towers of a peak difficulty do not have to be extremely punishing. Unless it's a soul crushing, then I guess, yeah, because soul crushings are naturally extremely punishing. Oh, I just dropped down here. Here's the ball jumps. Take note of their physics please take note of their physics. As it's known, as jumps like these can cause falls. Even with experienced. Now the invisible. No, seriously, what do you do here? What do I do?
Isn't the English language?
Okay. It's not fine anymore.
Oh, so it's just an invisible platform. Hey, no, I just would have continued. And yes, the jumps here are really stupid. What do you expect? It's a Ring 3 tower. There's almost always has to be that weird quirk with a. The tower's jump is boring. It's probably one of the. Or the earlier floors have to be extremely hard. And the later floors are ridiculously easy. Tower of Elysium is a great example of this. To be honest, it could be a great... This tower is a great example of how not to make a tower. So it's Tower of Hand Sweating, but... At least I had actually enjoyable gameplay at parts. This is not enjoyable. I'd go as far as to say that this is the exact opposite of enjoyable. I mean, unmarked conveyors. Jeez, unmarked conveyors. Now, what's this tower trying to... Tower of Fatness was literally made me want to do Tower of Confusion. Literally made me want to do Tower of Confusion with Literally made me want to do Tower of Confusion twice. Literally made me... It, like, that tower literally made me want to do Tower of Confusion. Of course, we have a conveyor. Because those are fair. And giant nightmare maze. Oddly enough, I managed to make out of it. And the first safety is unlocked. After that, we have another darker section. Just a simple section. Oh yeah, if you fall here, you on this outside section, you have to restart the entire tower. I know. But that's basically the gist of the outside section. That does not mean you get to include some of the stupidest jumps of any tower in it. But I'm pretty sure Ring 3 is known for awful towers. Some of these towers may make an appearance on GAT. Some of these towers probably make an appearance on GAT. Towers of Showers, because I haven't seen any news regarding GAT in God knows how long. Go behind this truss. What's this tower trying to train me for? Tower of Impossible Expectations? Of course, the classic, you have to do a head hitter instead. How do I fall for it? Oh yeah, I fell for it. I should treat... Look, if you've been a modern JToH player, for any amount of time, you would know that transparent platforms are supposed to be can collide false. That's horrid. This outside section is just horrid. I gotta tell you this again, this outside section is just horrid. Like, come on. Oh yeah, you have a chance to hit your head on that, so, yeah. And by the way, you have to restart the tower, even if you save yourself on the spheres. Because there's no way to get back inside through them. There's no balcony to save yourself on. Only possible parts you could save yourself on are... is that jump. Trouble on this tower than I do some challenging. I'm not kidding. Probably have a more fun time trying to beat tower difficulty a buff version of the tower difficulty chart. I'd probably rather do tower Pit of Misery Tower Rush. Yeah, that exists. But it only includes a repeat of Tower of Modernistic Design choices. Why does Tower of Modernistic Design choices exist? Oh God. Seriously, onto a thin stud? Tightrope. And we unlocked the new safety net. Don't know why I could just do that skip. They even thinking when they made this tower. And yes, that's a kill brick maze. A dark one at that. Why do they have to make a section that takes that much health? See the wind pad right there. They didn't expect this. Oh yeah, if you don't want to, oh yeah, if you don't feel like doing the final stretch, just walk along the frame. Then jump onto the wind pad. Anyways, like and subscribe, and we'll push notifications. This tower's a nightmare to beat. And bye.